Action. The first time I wasn't enthusiastic enough. I hope this is.
Right. We had to cut and refilm.
Yes.
For the enthusiasm.
Yes. Enthusiasm's
important. Yeah, that was great. Fantastic. Yeah. Good job.
Thank you very much. So today I'm doing this and she's got something fun to show you. Aprons. Well, aprons are handy. They're easy. And they are hand stamped by Elizabeth with her folk art floral stamps, which is what you're seeing there. And in today's video, she will show you how she went about this. These are really nice mid-weight denim aprons. They hook around your head. They have a tie at the waist. They are 100% cotton. They have two pockets. And even on an average short person like me, they come down to my knee. And on Elizabeth, who's, what, 3 inches taller than me? I'm 5'4" on a good day, and you're 5'7".
Yep.
It still comes down to her knee. So they are gonna work on just about everybody. And if you submit a qualifying order during the promotional period, so a qualifying order is one where you spend $50 or more on products other than gift certificates during the promotional period, and that date is going to be below because we're filming this and not entirely certain when we're going to schedule it, but we have 24 of these that not only did she stamp, she signed that we're going to give away.
I signed them. Yeah, I signed them all. And yeah, the expanded description box below the video will have the links to the foam stamps and also the information on the dates.
The promotional dates.
Yeah.
Start and finish.
So yeah, I signed every single one of them. We made a production line and I was stamping like crazy and Barb was sliding them in and folding them up and sliding them in and folding them up.
We had them laid out everywhere.
They were laid out everywhere. So it was kind of fun. We did it last night when it got dark, so we couldn't make any more videos. So we just started making aprons.
Yeah, we stamped and stamped and stamped and stamped. And
I think these are so cute though, aren't they? The stamps themselves.
Mm-hmm. Every time I work with them, I go, oh, they're so cute.
They are.
You just want to pinch their cheek if they had one.
If they had one. So what we're going to do is show you how to make your own in case you are not fortunate enough to receive one as a giveaway.
Yeah. You ready to go do it?
You ready to go do it?
Well, let's go do it.
Okay.
All right. We're going to do it.
Okay. So Barb and I made a production line out of these awesome aprons and we're going to be using them as a giveaway, but we wanted to show you how to make your own. So we are using my Folk Art Florals foam stamp collection, some of them. There are a few more flowers and a few more pieces to this collection. And we're also using Amsterdam acrylic paints. And these acrylic paints are brightly colored and they're permanent, so they are not going to come out if you launder the apron according to the directions on the apron itself. So I am making sure also that I'm using opaque colors so that they cover the dark fabric. You don't want to be using translucent colors because the blue will show through them and then they'll be dull. And we certainly don't want any dull colors. So I've got the paint on a gel plate off to the side to use as a palette. And basically the composition that I found I really like the best on these is with this fun flower in the middle. Top center. So I'm just putting out the paint and then dabbing into the surface of the paint and making sure I have really good coverage on the stamp. And then what's great about these is that they were folded, so there's a line down the middle, so you don't have to guess like where your center is. And I'm just going to put this one close to the top, right in the center. And you just want to make sure you apply pressure in the middle and around the edges. And then look at how cute that is. And then the stem to that stamp,
I have to roll this off on something.
Okay, I'm just gonna roll the brayer off to clean it for the most part, but now I'm going into like a yellow green for the stem. And I'm using the longest stem for that middle flower. And again, I'm just gonna dab it. Keep dabbing it onto the plate until I get good coverage. That's a great color, isn't it?
It's very pretty. I love those yellowy, acidy greens. I think they're so cool.
I think they're your favorite color, maybe.
They're darn close. I think they're a very close second to turquoise.
Look at that.
Look
so cute.
It's very cute. You know, every time we work with these
folk art florals.
Thank you. I was going to say long stem folk art florals. Too many stamps.
These are short stem.
Yes, well, that's a long stem.
Every time we work with these, we go, oh, isn't that cute? We do love these so very much.
We do. We really do. Okay, so, I mean, I do. So, and you know, I have stamped these on the bottom of my very long denim skirt, all around the bottom of the skirt. And just the other day, while Barb was here, I went to the store to grab something, and I literally had three people stop me to tell me how much they liked my skirt. So there's that.
Yes.
Okay, so now this one, we're going to put, the side ones, we're going to put slightly lower, so we have this kind of triangular composition. Woo! Okay. We're just going to keep going with that and put that here. It's not too bad.
It is right. What it is. You know what? Yep. That makes it unique from all the others.
Yes, it happens. Okay, so now we have that one. And then the next one is going to be pink on the other side, also slightly lower. So I'm blending two pinks here. Bit. You could always do an ombre too, where you kind of dip it in and you end up with a light pink and dark pink kind of mottled. Barb does that a lot and I always forget to do that. But you do that a lot with the foam stamps. You put like two or three colors on it. It always looks nice.
I always think it just makes it a little bit more realistic because no, there's very little flowers in that I can think of that they all look identical. All the colors are the same all the way across.
Exactly. But sometimes I forget, but yours always look nice that way. So, of course, you can mix two pinks partially and then dip it in there so you get like shading. Oh, look at that tulip.
Very cute.
All right. And then everybody's favorite color, teal. We're going to do the two side stems.
And you mixed a little bit of green in there just for fun.
Yeah, I just pulled a little bit of this green that was already on the plate. I used a different brayer so I didn't get any pink in it. And
You're going to use the same stem for both of those outside flowers, right?
Yes, I'm going to use the same stem. This is a different design, but it's also shorter. So it, again, gives you that kind of triangular composition.
And the other thing that I like is you angled those flowers in.
I did, and I'm going to angle these stems in a little bit.
It just makes it a little bit less boring than if they're all a straight line going across.
Definitely. We'll angle that one a little bit. Look at that.
Oh, so cute.
Right? And then, where was that marker I was using? Is it this one?
Yep, that's the one. And that's the cool thing. Every one of these that we've given away, Elizabeth will have signed.
I am signing with the POSCA Metallic.
It's a PC5M, sister.
PC5M. And the metallic is important because we sampled a couple of light-colored markers, and they didn't really show up on the denim. And I think the metallic just makes this stand up better.
I think it makes it a little bit more opaque.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm just going to sign it right up the side here. And perfect. There you have a hand-signed apron by me. I hope that you will be able to get one of these in the giveaway, but if not, I hope you will be inspired to create your own.
It's in the wind. My mouth just flaps.
So, the stamping process that we use to create the aprons is the same thing. Oh. Is the same thing as stamping on paper. So you already know how to do this if you've ever stamped on paper, used the gel plate to make stamped collage paper, whatever. It's just a different surface and we use the same old acrylic paint.
Nothing changes. I mean, the surface obviously is a little bit different, but the only thing I can think of is you might need a tiny bit more paint on fabric simply because of the way that it is. But other than that, and it's a test thing. Test. And yeah. You figure it out. I mean, it is truly, it's not a big deal. And if you grab these aprons, you could let your kids or the kids, your grandchildren do them for their parents or whatever. They make nice little gifts. Yeah. This is easy enough for kids to do, which I think is great.
Yeah, they make great little handmade gifts. So yeah. Anyway, yeah, you can do it.
You can do it.
All right. We'll see you next time.